cities as well around this, the challenges in the cities themselves, but also this issue of an urban-rural divide which seems to be coming clearer. Is this something that Eurocities is thinking about and working with?
Yeah, let me start with a statement. For me, the future of Europe and even in the world will be made by cities and regions. Why? Because I see that worldwide member states and national governments doesn't succeed in doing things. Yeah, if it's concerning war, if it's concerning fighting, if it's concerning having difficulties, they are very strong in it. But if you look for solutions, if you look for the future, if you look to find an answer to what the people is asking for their own future, for the children, for the families, it's always on the field of cities and regions that we have to give the answer. I can give you some examples. Climate change. Yeah? There is indeed the agreement of Paris. Just spoke about Paris. That's very good. But it was during years and years that didn't have an agreement between the member states. It was not possible to have an agreement. But in the meantime, all the cities worldwide have already the Covenant of Mayors. Worldwide, in Europe, we are organized very well. In America, they are organized. Canada is organized. Everywhere in the world, cities organize themselves together. And they can do things together. And the future of the world, and certainly in Europe, will be in the hands of sustainable, smart cities like Malmö is one of them. I think that cities who are have a policy like Malmö has are cities who are looking to the future. I give you a second example. The problems where we are confronted with here in Europe on the field of refugees. Yeah? The governments are discussing. Europe doesn't find any solution. But who has the problems? The cities. Because they all come in the cities. And there we have to find solutions. It are the mayors of the cities and the responsible of the cities who has to find the solutions for the problems where worldwide are confronted. But cities have to give the answer. It's everywhere the same. So that's the reason why in Eurocities we are so convinced that working together and change ideas, looking what other cities are doing, can give the answers and solutions for you, what you are doing. And that's even the same, that partnership is also worldwide, with the Global Parliament of Mayors. I should ask all those mayors who are here, or representatives of cities who are not member, please become member of the Global Parliament of Mayors. That's on world level where big cities are coming together, the mayors of big cities or vice mayors are coming together, where they try to find some solutions worldwide on different things. And what's concerning your basic question on democracy, when I was elected in November 16 as president of Eurocities, I launched a project that have the title now, Cities for Europe, Europe for Citizens. And what we are doing is now asking to our 142 cities to work, because we are the closest to the citizens, we are the closest to the inhabitants of cities, to ask to every citizens, what are you thinking about Europe, about the future of Europe? We are in deep crisis in Europe at this moment, as every European knows it, and even the other friends of the other parts in the world knows that Europe is in a deep crisis. We have to give an answer. And there was a call more than a year ago from Mr. Juncker, the president of the European Commission, who said, I have here a white paper for you, please tell me what we have to do with Europe. Well, I have said, let's ask it to the 140 million Europeans who are living in our cities. And what we are doing, Malmö is doing also, I just talked about it with my colleague, with Katrin, they are doing also efforts here. But for instance, in my city, I ask to all the inhabitants of my city, who wants to become the president of Europe for Ghent? And I have a lot of candidates. I said, okay, but you have to give me your program. What do you change in Europe now, you as an inhabitant of my city? And there's a lot of interest in the university, and that's very good. We have 75,000 students in the university. We have a rather big university, and that's very good, because there we have a lot of young people who give ideas for the future of Europe. Some of them, you cannot do anything with it, but there are very good ideas. We're going to put them all together. And now in November, we have in Edinburgh, and we especially go to the UK, because, you know, as we talked about the Brexit, we are going especially to the UK to say, UK, please stay in Europe, and we are coming with our European cities to Edinburgh in November now, where we're going to put all the ideas together and bring them to the European Commission. So I am very convinced of the fact that if we put some energy in it, and if the cities and the mayors and the vice mayors and the governance of the cities and the regions are working with their people, that we can refight the trust in Europe and in policy in general.
And that city-region partnership, is that going to solve the urban-rural issues as well?
That depends from country to country. I see that in some countries there's really a fight between the rural boards and the cities. Huh? In other countries there is more, how do you call it in English? A region, the city and the region together, where they work together. That's also something that I try to do. I work together with 17 municipalities and communities who are around the city to work together. We have the same fire brigade, for instance. We work on the same economic development. For me, if there is a new enterprise, it doesn't have to be on the territory of Ghent. If it's outside of Ghent, it's also good for our people. They can go working there too. So we work together in all these kind of things. But I think on partnership, you have to do two things. Cities who want to belong to the future also, I always say to my colleagues, please don't think on a short term. Don't think to the next elections. Think on a long term. Think about what is the future for our children and grandchildren. Think about this. And you're going to be re-elected. Even if it's in 2 years elections, please work on the future. The people will see it and you will be re-elected. I know it from experience, my own experience. I always worked for the future. And yes, I'll give you one example. We made a new mobility plan in our city. We put out all the cars of the city center. You cannot drive anymore through the city. You have to drive around the ring. We divided the city in 6 pieces, like a cake. And you can go from the one piece to the other one. You have to take always the ring. So everybody was against. We installed it 1st of April last year. So we are now 1 year further. And we have done a scientific question to the people, and we have already 55% in favor. And I am convinced that if you dare to take measures that are good for the people in the city, you're going to be re-elected. I'm so convinced. And that's what you have to do. That's what I always say to my colleagues. Don't be afraid if there is one who sent you an email that you are a donkey and that you know anything and so on. Put it away. Know that there are thousands of people who say he has ideas or she has ideas for our city, and go on, please go on. That's the only way that we can put the cities also and the people, that we can assure a future, sustainable future for the next generations.
It's an interesting dynamic, this between a very strong leadership and the grassroots process, and getting that fine line between when do you stick your neck out and go against what you know is popular opinion, because you think that you're going to be right and you think you're going to get the right results. This is a really challenging situation. And I'm thinking in Colombia you've had some similar work, not least around mobility, which has been a lot of strong leadership. Has that had the same kind of public resistance initially, or has that had popular support all the way through?
In the last year, maybe 2 years ago, we have a very similar process like a Brexit, because in Colombia we lost a referendum for the peace, and people who's believing in the ideas like if you vote or if you vote for yes, the peace and referendum, you make it homosexual. It's a stupid idea. Things I think in Colombia, we need I don't want to speak to you to the political problems in Colombia only, because we need to see more things, because at the Green Party have a very responsibility in the democracy in Colombia. It's not only political ways or political fields, because our objectives in participation or in democracy in Colombia are I need to connect in Spanish, sorry.